With me now, I have Zerlina Maxwell, director of Progressive Programming, Sirius XM, former director of Progressive Media, the Clinton campaign. CNN political commentator Doug High, former spokesman for the Republican National Committee, and Derek Green, a city councilman at large for the city of Philadelphia and a graduate of the University of Virginia in Charlottesville. So welcome to all of you. And Zerlina, let me just turn to you. Watching that, someone sent me that Vice video. First thing this morning I saw it. It makes you ill.
Yes.
How do you feel about that? How do you feel about what we heard from the president and the fact that he has no regrets today?
I'm really sad. This is a sad moment for the country, and I think not surprising, though, because Donald Trump essentially stoked a lot of this vitriol and hatred through the course of his campaign. I said last year he normalized racism. He made it okay to come outside in public without anything on your face and to proudly say, blood and soil, and to call for the extermination of Jews and people of color. And so we have to be really clear that what the president did yesterday is take the side of neo-Nazis and the Ku Klux Klan, which is anti-American. It's unacceptable. And I think that Republicans in this moment have this is a really big moral test for them. To say Donald Trump's name, not just call out white supremacy and racism, that's the easy layup. Which Donald Trump missed, but also say that what Donald Trump said is unacceptable.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Doug High, to you. You wanted to get on, I understand, because you emailed the White House and said, stop sending me your talking points.
Yeah, you know, in an alternative universe, Brooke, I'd be disagreeing with everything that Zerlina said and telling you exactly why she's wrong. The reality is I agree with a lot of what she said, and it really makes me sad, not just as a Republican, but as an American. And I can tell you, as a Republican, somebody who really cares about the party and the policies that it prescribes, it's not just what President Trump said, as awful as that was. I look at the comments that were made about Barack and Michelle Obama time and time again. Maybe it wasn't to the level of the president, but if it's a state party treasurer, if it's a congressional staffer, if it's a member of Congress making a stupid joke about Kenya, it makes people think that racism is endemic to the Republican Party, that it's some kind of a native flora. And so if I'm talking to friends of mine who are African-American or Hispanic or gay and lesbian, and they ask me about why should they support the Republican Party, I can't answer them about policy, because all they hear is that my party doesn't like them. And if that's the message that they hear, the Republican Party will die.
On the Republican Party, here's the point on a lot of these members of senior leadership. They are denouncing racism, which frankly is easy to do. It's a political layup, as Zerlina just said. You know, the only one who's actually called out the president is John McCain, who said there is no moral equivalency between racists and Americans standing up to defy hate and bigotry. The president of the United States should say so. Derek, do you think they should? Do you think they need to go that far?
Absolutely, Brooke. And first and foremost, our thoughts and prayers go out to the Heyer family, who was funeralized today, as well as to Lieutenant Cullen and Trooper Bates, who were also lost in this tragic event. But I agree with Doug, and I commend Doug for making his statement, as well as Senator McCain. More Republican leaders need to state the facts. What Donald Trump said was repugnant to the presidency, to our country, and we need more Republican leaders to do that. And it's a shame. As a graduate of the University of Virginia, I'm really pained by what happened at my campus at Charlottesville. And the fact you would have a UVA graduate, Richard Spencer, do this type of event at the University of Virginia, where we all took an honor pledge, is really repugnant and deplorable. And we need to make sure that we call out racism and neo-Nazism and white supremacy for what it is. And I wish more Republican leaders would do what Doug just did and call out the president for his statements and backtracking.
We heard the man, Zerlina, in the video talking about, and I wrote down the quote, something like, he said something like, watch that Kushner bastard walk around with that beautiful girl,
right,
being the president's daughter, who is Jewish,
yes,
as is the son-in-law,
yes,
as is Gary Cohn and Steve Mnuchin, two men high up in the administration who stood behind the president yesterday. What do you think they need to do to send a message to the president?
Resign.
Resign.
Yes. I think that the fact that we're even at 3 o'clock in the afternoon the following day after what we saw yesterday, nearly 24 hours later, and no one has resigned, condemning it, saying that you are uncomfortable or saying that the president went rogue, is not enough in this moment. You have to take a stand against this. This is going to get worse. This, what we saw in Charlottesville, is just the tipping point, because now racists have been emboldened by this president. David Duke said thank
We've
you for what
responses.
You said, Mr. President.
Yes.
And so now it's a moment in which if you are opposed to the Klan, you need to say so. And and you have to do more than just condemn it with words. You need to get up and walk out of the White House.
Doug, do you agree? Should Gary Cohn walk out of the White House?
Well, you know, I really don't know, to be honest with you. Look, these are obviously very troubling times within the White House, and people should be troubled. I also think there are a lot of good, smart people at the White House, and we need good, smart people at the White House and the other agencies and departments to make sure that we can get Donald Trump the best advice that he can. He's obviously not following it, but I don't know, just looking in my own heart, if I think everybody resigning en masse, while it's a grand statement, I don't know if that's the best thing for the country right now.
Derek, do you agree? I mean, the risk of these people resigning, Trump would, we don't know who the president would replace them with.
Well, I disagree. I mean, I was taught at a very young age that actions speak louder than words. And we've had a lot of words from the president. We've had, you know, Congressman Ryan and others make statements, but not really condemning the president. And so we need action. We need members of his cabinet to take action. From the members of the cabinet, from Dr. Ben Carson, Elaine Chao, Jared Kushner, the fact that Jared Kushner, who is a man of Jewish faith, and this white nationalist, Cantwell, made those horrific statements about Jared Kushner and about
what's Jared
Donald
Kushner supposed to do?
Trump's
he married the president's daughter.
Absolutely, but he should take some action. Just like in the earlier segment that you played, you had a family call out their son for becoming a neo-Nazi. We need to take action, and we cannot sit in a situation where people whisper behind closed doors or talk about the things they say is negative but won't say it publicly or take the next step in taking action.
I appreciate the conversation. We're going to leave it. Derek and Doug and Zerlina, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.